Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about how to do the Predator effect test. It's basically the cloaking effect that was used in the Predator movies, or a simplified version of. This is what it looks like. As you can see, I'm acting like a complete tool in front of the camera, but that was filmed for a different shot. I just use a different background for this. If you want to see that video, you can click the link at the end of this video and see the original video we use that footage for. Anyway, here we go. So first thing you need to do is create a new comp. It's a new composition. Mine's full HD, so we'll just leave it at that. And we're going to call this one, we'll call the comp main. If I could learn how to type, that would be good. Okay, now we're going to bring our footage in. Sorry, I've got a previous comp in here, so I'll just get rid of that. We'll bring our footage in, which is our background layer and our keyed footage as well. The keyed footage is just me being a complete fool in front of a green screen. Okay, so bring the keyed footage down to your timeline. And your background down under that. I'm going to highlight the background layer now and press Control Shift C. Going to call this basically, we're going to pre-comp it so we can play around with it a little bit more. So we're going to call this background. Move all attributes into the new composition and do open new composition. Tick that box as well. Now it automatically took us into the background comp. That's why the actors disappeared. So what we need to do now, click on the new comp up here, right click on that and do composition settings. Now we need to be able to scale the background image up about 25%. So when you do the Predator effect, the background can wrap around the effect. If you don't do this, it sometimes the edges shrink in and you get black, weird black sort of squiggly lines and so on. So it's not always the best way to do it. So just when you're in here, select the log aspect ratio, make sure that's ticked. Double click or just single click on there and just click next to it again and just do asterisk 1.25 and do OK. Now what that does is increase the comp size up a little bit. You can now go down to your selected background layer and hit S and the scale, and you can change that scale to 125 so it matches. That way it fits beautifully. Okay, now we're going to do the green screen footage. So we'll go into the main comp again. And there's the key footage here. As you can see, they're both together. But if you want to scale this up as well, you can. Now's the time to do it after, well, basically after you've comped it. So this one here again, you want to do Control Alt C again. Make sure you've selected your keyed footage or your actor, whichever way you want to call it. Control Alt C. Sorry, Control Shift C, and call this one actor. Now this time we're going to untick that open new composition because we don't want to go straight into that comp. Now you've got them both pre-comped. Now we've got that going, select your background. If you want to scale, by the way, if you want to scale this actor one up to match the rest of the background, you can double click on it and you'll go into the comp. And we can just go hit select and press S and scale that 125% as well if you want to match your footage, for instance. Go back into your main comp again, select your background comp, just single click. Go Effect, Distort, Displacement Map. Now a lot of people think that you're actually going to mess with the background. Sorry, you're going to mess with the green screen footage or the keyed out footage. The actual thing, what you're really doing is you're just using that as a reference point and you manipulate the background to suit. So you go up to Displacement Map layer up here and just change that tick box to Actor. And where it says use for horizontal displacement, select that and just go luminance. Max horizontal displacement, make that 55. Actually, make that 50. And with the green layer, select that and go luminance as well, and make the next one 50 as well. Now your effect is basically done, even though you can't see anything. If you look at the footage, you can still see the actor. But what we've done is we've taken the actor's movements, and we've now using it as a reference point for the background. So if you actually take the eye off the actor, you can now see the movement of your predator effect. It just wraps the background around that image. No matter how that moves around, the background will just blend around your image. And I'm throwing punches because it was for a different video, so it looks a bit silly at the moment. Shadow boxing in an alley as a predator. But hey, we all do things when we're bored. All right, so that's basically it. If you turn that back on, you'll obviously see me again. So what you do now is you render it out, and your video is done. If you have any questions, feel free to let us know. Like and subscribe if you want to see more of our vids, and I'll see you next time for the next tutorial. Thanks.